Alright, Apple versus Dell, the M2 MacBook Air versus XPS 13. Two very premium yet modest laptops. Let's go over the raw stats. The M2 MacBook Air is Apple's mildly entry-level laptop that starts at $1,200, while the XPS 13 was recently redesigned by Dell with some new features, starting at $1,000. Now, given that these have a bit of a price difference, we'll see which one comes out on top. Next, form factor. The M2 MacBook Air sports a 13.6-inch Retina display with a great resolution and Apple True Tone, which in person looks mwah. And while the XPS 13 doesn't have as good of a resolution, it does come with an on-par brightness level and some extremely thin bezels, which do show off its also very beautiful display. Now, I will say that at this point in display tech, most things will look quite beautiful at this price range. So there will be a bit more differentiation in the next few sections, such as with connectivity. And man, this is won by a landslide. Apple used to previously confine its laptops to only a few ports in favor of a more minimalist design language. However, over the past year, the company's been slowly undoing that, and the list is on the screen. It's not great, but it's better than what we usually get. And in comparison to the XPS, yeah, it's better. Yeah, the XPS 13 doesn't come with that many ports. However, I do have one compliment. Unlike Apple with most of its laptops, Dell separated the USB-C ports on different sides, so you have some flexibility on what side you charge your laptop on. But the M2 MacBook Air still takes the cake with this section. Now, let's discuss the cameras. And Apple does kinda cheat with this one, because if you have an iPhone, you can use it as an external cam for your laptop. But the laptop also has a built-in 1080p camera, while the XPS 13's is 720p, which frankly is still fairly adequate for most typical applications, but the MacBook Air is still better. So for the external summary, the M2 MacBook Air has a better form factor, connectivity, and camera, while the XPS 13 has a better price. Now, let's get on to the internal specs, which are acceptable for both parties. The M2 MacBook Air comes with a new, yes, M2 chip, while the XPS 13 comes with the new 12th gen Intel processors. And both are great, but the M2 MacBook Air is a bit better. Here are the benchmarks. Now, this is where things take a turn. Storage. The XPS 13 comes with 512GB, which is not great, but it's better than the MacBook Air, with the $200 more expensive laptop sporting 256GB, which is Apple got stingy with this one, so nice job Dell. But bringing it back to Apple again, the MacBook Air does have a better battery life than the XPS 13. On average, Apple advertises 18 hours, with most people getting around 12-ish, which is still amazing, while the XPS 13 on average has gotten just a little less. So they're both good, but Apple takes the win for this one. For security, both laptops have their own features that will ensure your laptop is safe. And for operating systems, the MacBook Air runs macOS, while the XPS 13 runs Windows 11. So for the internal summary, the M2 MacBook Air has better internal specs and battery, while the XPS 13 has better storage. So, which laptop is best? Well, before I get started, if you are in the market for the M2 MacBook Air, you should also compare it to the Dell XPS 13 Plus, not the normal, which is a little bit more so in the price range of the MacBook, so the comparison doesn't seem too one-sided. And yet, the raw stats comparison isn't won by a landslide in this, as it would seem. Yeah, the MacBook Air does perform better and has far better connectivity, but the XPS is right behind it with its better storage and lower price. The MacBook Air does have far more frills than the XPS from a design standpoint, such as with its screen and also its UI, such as with the continuity cam feature that allows you to use your phone as a webcam. But even still, those are just add-ons to your experience. What about the stuff that really matters? Well, the decision when it comes to these laptops and their raw stats really comes down to the operating systems fitting your needs and then your personal preferences. Let's first focus on those needs, because we gotta get them out of the way. So, what are your needs? Well, in this case, they can probably be compiled into two general sections. Remember, these are needs, not wants. So we're gonna focus on what you have to do with these laptops. So for a typical student or professional using these devices, you'll probably be running programs that are tailored toward either macOS or Windows. For instance, Final Cut Pro is only run on Macs, while Notepad++ is only on Windows. So, if you have specific apps that can only be run on a specific device, you gotta get that device. And I would extend this to your tech ecosystem. For instance, if you've previously had Macs or you work with a lot of Macs, it would be to your benefit to get one as well. Or if you and your colleagues work with a lot of Windows computers, it would be to your benefit to get one of those. And once you get those needs out of the way, then it's time for personal preference. preference. If you like a device because it does this or that and it fits your needs, then you should get it. Just make sure it covers all your boxes and you'll be good to go. And that was my M2 MacBook Air versus XPS 13 comparison. I hope this helped and saved you a little time too. My name is Cyrus. It's spelled like Cyrus, but not like Seerooster. Just take out the terror. Thank you very much for watching and have a wonderful day. Peace.